Hello everybody, it's me, Tom, and I'm here for a live stream. So, who have we got today? We've just got Chris and Anthony because that's all I wanted here. Hello you two. Okay, don't speak then, don't care, don't really like you anyway, so whatever. Lol. Anthony? Chris? Hello?
Hello?
Oh, you can
hear
me. I did wonder then.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, everybody. It's me, Tom, and I'm here
for my God.
Live stream.
I didn't realise that I had the live stream thing, the audio available. Anyway, so we are at Blaenau Ffestiniog. Hopefully I've pronounced that right. You do realise I'm not going to be able to pronounce anything right in this video, right? Right. Guys? Can you two just not hear me or what?
Huh?
Can you not hear me?
We can.
You're cutting out a lot.
Oh, it's probably because I'm uploading. Well, can you hear me now?
Yes.
Good. Gaze. Anyway, I'm going to have to come off of the streamer thing because that might help with the settings.
He said.
Anyway, I'm just going to check the route. Yeah, so we're driving from here all the way to there. This is going to be a fun journey, is it not? We're going to have fun. Anyway, without further ado, it's now 7 o'clock, so let's see how long it actually takes us to drive from one end to the other.
Yay!
So, let's talk. What is our noble steed for tonight's festivities?
Well, why don't you have a look at the stream and tell me?
It's a freak. Where's the back end?
Has it got a back end?
Oh.
Well, this died very quickly.
Exactly.
I'm just looking at what you're doing.
No, you're not, young lady.
Can't discuss things, Tom. We're scared.
Why?
No, I can't do social.
Please don't.
Oh, I don't care. I got a face. I need to eat it.
No, you don't.
Please. I do not know Michael Fame. What is that intro music?
There isn't any intro music, is there?
No.
According to Michael Fame, there is. Anyone who played ES 2018, what the fuck is that intro music?
Oh, it doesn't matter. TF 2017, 18 even.
So, Tom, what do you think of this route so far?
I actually really like it. I didn't used to like narrow gauge that much, but after driving this, it sort of looks quite accurate to the actual Welsh Highland and Ffestiniog that I've seen in videos, so.
That's nice.
Do we need to drag more people in here?
Yes.
Yes! I don't want this responsibility. I'm just a kid.
Well, I don't know who you want to drag in, but,
you decide.
Actually, choose. We've got Gareth, James Allison, Logan, that's muted, Stu, Ethan, and Great Brook.
Well, why don't you ask them which ones want to come up, because, yeah.
Alright, hang on.
Look, I found some sheep! Oh my goodness! If Reese is ever watching this,
God.
Look, I just found your, well, I just found one of your ex-lovers.
My God, there's definitely proof we're in Scotland, then.
Let's see how well this goes. Wait. Anyone want to be beamed up?
Oh, Scotty, fuck off.
Beam me up, Scotty. Beam me up, Scotty Manine, sure.
Beam
That's
me up, Scotland.
Right, we'll get Logan, Mr. Ellison,
Manine.
Matenna.
Matwenty.
Do we want anyone else, or should we leave it there for now?
Bring in Luke as well, he's alright.
No, Luke's all relaxed.
Okay. Hello.
See? Told you.
It's Skywalker.
Right, that gives me some less responsibility to actually talk for a bit. I can concentrate on driving, because this is going to be a bit of a long one.
So,
we're
going to
be your... We are your comedy, Tom. We have to control the people.
Well, then you're not comedy. You're never comedy.
I'm not comedy. I'm never
the
comedy.
The only comedy we get is when you fall off on me.
I'm a chair.
This is going off to a good start.
It always does, Chris. Especially when I set up.
Well, no, Logan, that's where it goes downhill.
You know shit hits the fan when James Ellison turns up, though.
Oh, wait. Don't be rude to the American. Just because he's American, Logan.
He just turns up with AK-47s, so I'm still doing with a Mr. Kipling cake.
That's the Russians.
No.
Yes, because they have AR-15s.
Nudes. Yeah, they have those. Yeah, but the Americans have like shotguns.
No, Americans have AR-15s. The Russians have the AKs. Don't worry, Logan. I know about guns.
Disclaimer, ladies and gentlemen, we have no idea what these two idiots are rambling about. Please then stand by for technical difficulties.
Beep!
Beep!
This could take a while, so...
You're in a Big Brother's house. Please do not swear.
Fuck.
Feck.
Oh, fuck. You broke the walls.
Don't swear in my house, you fucking bastards.
Captain America says, watch your language. Oh, wait, too late for that.
Ooh.
What's your language, says Captain America? I just slapped a bitch up.
You silly tosser.
It's funny, you think about it. He says that in Age of Ultron, then later he swears.
There are no
swears. Yeah, that's the running gag. They use it quite a lot. If you notice, like, at the party, they're like, don't use that language. Yeah, and it's also like at the party bit, they're like, oh, watch your language, guys. Captain might tell you off. And it's like, seriously, you told everyone about that?
Anyways, guys.
Chris.
I shall be right back. I need to head into the break room real quick.
Get out!
No!
Chris, you have destroyed the museum already with your antics.
Bonk.
I will be right back.
He's going off to bonk the sheep. Oh, wait, that's Reese's job. Oh.
Oh.
If Reese were here, he'd had some kind of witty comeback.
Probably
not. No, he would not.
But no, because Reese is Welsh.
And so he has to just accept it.
This is not the angry Welsh team, this is the Dart DJ team. The second-rate what?
What? Our favourite number is 420 and 69.
A bag of weed, a bag of weed.
Which proves why...
I like this passenger view that you got going, Tom.
Yeah, well, it's just a bit different from sitting around the cab, isn't it? Gets you all the scenery hanging out the window.
You heard the phone, sorry.
Didn't hear anything, thank God.
Oh, can I share my...
I'm going to make Britain come on, silly.
You can share your wank fetishes with us, Anthony.
Who's sharing what?
Can I share the amusing story of what happened when I loaded up when we played on this the first time?
No.
Let's hear it.
Yeah, basically, I got this route because we were going to do a little race for it. I had not read the readme and I didn't realise we needed the chorus route for it. So, lo and behold, I spent the about 10 minutes driving around in a Class 14 along what was basically a path.
Haha.
Uh-huh. Oh.
Do you not have a chorus?
No. Oh, by the way, that also reminds me of some... let me just get my armchair voice. Oh my god, that is very inauthentic! The Ffestiniog is not 2'3" gauge!
How about you fuck off?
Get over it.
Oh, fuck off, you
yeah.
It's a representation, it's not 100% accurate, anyway.
It's a replica,
it's
good for fun!
2049. Where 1400s are gauged to 2'3" and the Talith Slim Railway engines are gauged to 4'8.5".
Can you imagine a 4'8.5" gauge double fairly though?
Oh boy.
Right, Tom, I know what we're building now.
Oh no.
The new build double fairly.
You're giving them ideas.
It's gonna be western's right. It's gonna have a western side and a southern side.
Oh no.
one side's gonna be an M7, the other's gonna be a Panier.
Oh my.
Oh, this is.
I like what Chris put.
Anyway, this stream should hopefully give a good indication of what this route is actually like anyway. I know the stream quality is going to be rubbish still, but...
One day, Tom. One day.
Very soon.
But that is never.
It's not under the stream. It's not the computer really that's the problem. It's the internet.
Yeah.
So what money's going to go through next?
Killing people.
Oh really, Chris?
What did Chris put now?
He just put also Anthony smells.
Oh, I just got that.
Yeah, just because he spends time with Olympic doesn't mean...
I'm sorry, Logan, I don't spend my time scavenging around in a scrapyard.
No, you go deeply diving, that's why you hang out with Olympic.
Wait, what's happening?
Well, I'm sorry, Logan, I'm not a professional diver, I can't compete in the Olympics.
What's this about finding scrapyard on Olympics?
Well, you are skinny enough to be streamlined, ain't you, you bony bastard?
I can't sing
bonk.
For copyright reasons.
What, bony bastard?
Reasons, this audio cannot be played.
Streamline!
Stream.
Mushrooms.
A standard gauge fairly equals Big Bertha joiner. Okay, huh?
I don't get that.
Big Bertha was not fairly. Or double.
I'm fairly sure that she was not a fairly. Haha, did a funny!
What?
I think Tom just did a joke.
I swear to God, I just heard Tom say, ha ha ha, I have a funny.
No, I said, ha ha ha, I did a funny, you idiot.
Oh.
I'm going deaf.
Yes, you are.
But Streamline fairly, oh my.
In other news, I have a new firing turn at Didcot.
No, you don't.
Is it with Thomas?
Yeah, it's with the little blue bastard.
Ooh.
And three of us in the cab.
Wait, you say with Thomas, like, what engine's that? Is that Jesse or is that the mid-hands one?
I'm not sure yet, I don't even know. I want it to be the mid-hands one, because that's a really good one to fire. Mainly because it's got a brick arch.
Let's put it this way, you can definitely tell which is which when you look at them.
Yeah.
If you're not seeing it yet.
No, because I haven't arrived. It arrives... I think it arrives around 25th-ish.
Apparently someone thinks that Logan needs a hearing aid.
Yes, he does.
Yeah. I'll nick one off my granddad.
Streamline sheep.
Oh, streamline sheep. That'd be the fastest lamb. But no, it'll be really cramped, depending on the engine.
For anyone who eats land, that's fast food.
In October, we had, what did we have in October?
We had Jesse.
And that was shite to fire.
Oi, don't diss Jesse. Jesse deserves to get out of its shitty Thomas phase.
Wait, Jesse... Isn't Jesse online Gotland?
Yeah, it's the ex-Hunslet 16-inch, I think.
Yeah, it'd be nice if it was actually a real engine instead of a little blue bastard. Because the problem with Jesse is it doesn't have a brick arch or anything. But apparently, the mid-ants one has got casing on it. And apparently it's got superheaters, but I've never seen the inside of the smoke box. Because we had Jesse last time, and I scared kids with Jesse.
Hmm. Were you making them cry, though, like a certain song we know?
Well, yeah, they do cry when you open the smoke box door of Thomas in front of them.
Yeah. Oh my god, he's opening his face!
Thomas is dead!
Says, hey, Tom and company, I was wondering if your favorite looking for this, however... LNER look is, however, you're not allowed to answer a Scotsman. Not that some. Anyway.
That wouldn't be a problem.
Sorry, I don't know what Scotsman is. My favorite, actually, I'm gonna answer honestly. My favorite. No, I'm gonna answer honestly for once. My favorite LNER engine is probably, GNR, number one.
Hmm. I'll say like as it. Long as it's not LMS, I'm good.
Oi!
My least favourite engine, anything made by, anything made by the LMS, except for Black Frives.
You are a naughty boy, Logan. And we're on a roller coaster, apparently, now.
What are you going to do, Anthony? Spank me?
Right, come on, then. Come on, little one.
No comment.
Oh, shit, I've just realized that's been broadcast live, hasn't it? I'm sorry, officer.
I'm sorry, officer, no. You
I'll tell you
no
what, it's been great for in a few years' time when you're trying to get a job, Anthony.
Sir, we believe we've uncovered this video of you saying you will spank this 15-year-old child.
This is when we need Callum here to do the crybaby.
Great.
Don't mention that.
He made me do it? How can a child make you do this, sir?
So, anything interesting happened while I was gone?
Well, Anthony just killed himself, basically.
Oh, nice.
What is that noise?
English Electric Studios, in reference to Scotsman, says, I saw the big galloping green sausage last Saturday, Sunday.
I swear to God, I wish you'd just stay where it was with his middle driving wheels taken out.
It's the ugliest fucking... Well, it's not the ugliest, it's just the shittiest.
It went to Didcot and it was more hassle than it's worth.
Well, we made it to this, like, this station, so that's good.
Tom likes stations.
I'm not gonna lie, I'd like to see Scotsman just say I saw it, but beyond that, nah.
Guys, real quick.
Feel slow.
Seb, yes, that is true, but only because of the Black Death, and, we got ourselves back because we realized how shit you guys were.
Oh, thank God, thanks.
Love it? Oh. Alright.
What's wrong, Chris?
Nothing.
What's up, Ted?
Oh my God!
There's a prostitute at the door.
Apparently, Didcot is the GWR retirement.
What? Well, GWR retirement? Really... What?
Well, it's true.
I didn't hear what he said. What was said?
Gareth, I think it is, said Didcot equals GWR retirement home.
Fuck off, Gareth, you little wang stain. I'll come to your house, take your brony dolls, and stick them up your arse.
Oh.
Food.
Arse.
Apparently someone wants something in Barry's voice.
What?
Well, no, I don't know, because you can't answer that question because Andy isn't here.
What?
His son is.
I think
can you say something in Barry's voice?
In Barry's voice?
Yeah, go on, represent your father here.
But you... Sure, Mum. I can cut myself if I want to.
Oh.
What? Chicken pies? Fuck off, it's all about fish fingers.
Wow.
Fish fingers and custard. We're ahead.
National Railway Museum of York equals mixed race retirement.
I swear to God, every... Wouldn't it be weird if, like, I was just realized something?
Well then.
NRM.
Valley Workshop is the graveyard.
There's that Bully Pacific that's like cutting off, isn't it?
Yeah.
This, if the engines could talk and stuff, would that engine either be in pain or dead?
It would probably be dead.
Oh, speaking of the NRM.
Hmm.
Sorry, Logan, you carry on.
So does that mean that like these engines are all sat around chatting whilst there's a dead corpse in the corner? Hey, what's up with Jerry over there? Oh, he's been dead for quite a few years. They can't map and show how an engine works.
Oh yeah, that's probably actually what's...
Speaking of the NRM, did any of you see that, the new Soul Slopes that Chris Eden Green put up today?
D-Class.
Yeah, and you know how he ends it with the, it's never steamed. Yet.
I reckon he's probably saying, they're probably going to give it to someone and they're going to go, yeah, they'll steam it.
Can you imagine if they just turn around and they're like, right, we don't need this anymore, we've got too many of these 440 things that nobody likes. Oh, I know, we'll give it to the Bluebell Railway.
Yeah, why?
To be honest, it would be quite a home at the Bluebell.
Yeah, it would actually.
Someone has just officially summoned LOL.
Yeah, but is the 737 like one of about two Southeastern and Chatham engines in preservation, not at the Bluebell?
Well, it was the only one not at the Bluebell. I think we should just nickname Bluebell to Southeastern and Chatham. SE and CPR.
Oh.
Southeastern and Chatham Preserve Railway. I'm gonna drive a 4200. I'm mad.
No, you're not, young man.
Why yes, not, Tom?
Because I said no.
Oh, you know what? I'm an emo though, so I can do whatever the fuck I want.
No, you can't. I'll send Anthony to your house. I'll send Anthony to your house. And he'll lick your head off.
But he's just downstairs cutting himself with his girlfriend.
I don't eat emo ice cream, John. It's not allowed.
Oh.
Also, I will just point out, for the first time in forever, I'm actually agreeing with Seb.
About what?
Wow.
That's Eagle's last masturbators.
What are you agreeing with Seb about? I can't say anything.
He wow, he said in chat, that. LMS equals large masturbators.
Thanks. Hey, wow. You all.
A Danish person agreeing with
Norwegian. Don't worry, it's that's not just that. It's large masturbating slots.
I think you don't remember I like the LMS.
Oh, yeah, right. No, LMS is the best. I'm going to completely brown nose now.
Get the fuck out of my house.
I'm not in your house. And the only way you can get me out of your house... It's
by being,
it
by being a racist, isn't it? Oh.
Oh, wait, what? Bless you.
Let's see. Charlie Gamish, GWR the racers, LMS the business, LNER the show us. What does that make the Sutherland just there?
I call them the innovators.
Foreigners.
I need to see this in my local movie theater next time I go see a movie. Cheetos popcorn.
Huh?
Only an American would say something like that.
Yeah, that's.
I must go to the cinema immediately because I want some popcorn because I'm fat.
Well, it is James.
Tom, you are fat.
It is James Ellison saying it, so.
Oh.
Oh.
Ooh.
Yeah, don't be rude.
Ouch! That's so racist.
Everyone here is all friends, come on now.
No, we're not young lady.
Except for me and Tom, we're bitter enemies.
We are indeed, we're enemies to the end.
Chris. Yeah, it's only because we're equals in Duck Game.
Chris?
No, so you two doing one thing.
It's all about that empire.
Huh?
It's all about the empire.
The empire? Well,
oh, not. No, please, no. Logan, don't. Not, no. I will talk about anything other than that.
Are you talking the empire from...
Excuse me!
I said Skyrim.
I'm talking about my Minecraft empire.
Oh, that's right then, as long as you're talking about the other thing.
No, I'm talking about Skyrim.
Oh, what? You mean Space Trek?
Yeah, clearly.
Space Trek? What?
Jesus Christ. Let's just... Moving on. Or...
Moving to
Moving along.
Move along.
Oh no, there's an engine coming towards me. Maybe I should stand my ground. I'm that way of right
oh
now.
No!
Tom, I think that engine just fell off a cliff.
I don't like this.
But the Fairlie, don't be mean to the Fairlies.
I reckon it should do a 257.
Actually,
Narrow gauge 257.
Are we just giving away spoilers from the DR?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah,
just mentioned it, Tom. Don't look at the track.
Don't look at the track or the chat.
Chat.
Why?
Oh, fucking
look at the train, don't look at the chat.
Seb, you fucking... Yeah, just don't look.
Why? What's happened?
Seb's being a cunt. Seb's being a cunt as usual.
Right.
No, he's not being a cunt. That's just joking.
Oh, James Wright is going for you, Anthony.
No, James. No.
Good, James.
No, bad.
Oh, James, did you stab those 14 children locked in your basement? Yeah.
Alright, let's not.
Can we not start that sort of thing here, Logan, please?
I'm sorry.
Jesus.
Talking to the Fairlies, so, which one would you say is your favourite, then, out of the bunch?
What, out of the three that are in the game?
Yeah.
I don't know, actually. Probably Meriden Emrys.
I have a soft spot for the Earl. It's a shame she's going out of traffic.
Well, I do like Earl of Meriona for a little bit, because she's the unique one of the three, isn't she?
Because she's green.
Except the fact that now she's sort of being taken apart and being turned into James Spooner.
What's going to happened with her again?
Her power bogies are being taken off and being used to build the replica James Spooner.
Hang on, I thought they were... they changed their minds on that. They were going to build a new set of power bogies for her.
I don't fucking know. Why don't you go ask them?
Alright, Elder Marionne, are they taking your power bogies?
Maybe.
Yes.
Or are they going to take your wheels away? And you're going to sit in the field for always and always and always and always.
And oh, always.
Fine. Gareth put it in there. My favourite, reference to the Fairlies, is the one that is actually running. What?
The one that's actually running is probably David Lord George. Like, on
they
the actual...
See with George.
I like the one that's in... Because there's three. There's one in, like, a light red. One in a maroon. And then one in the green. And then
the light red one is Lloyd George, isn't it?
The one I'm driving is David Lord George.
I like the darker one.
That'd be murdering then. What are the Fairlies Lights driving game then? Because I know they look like MSTS converts, but...
They're quite good. The whistles are like...
Alright, I guess.
They're better than the Traflin engine, the lighter.
How are people liking the stream so far anyway? I mean, as in... It's nice to see a like something a bit different in it on these strings.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh god, just bridge. Let's look at live chat. See what's happening.
Ah, oh, screw it. I'm gonna load up.
Where is Barry?
On Talithlin.
The question of today, where is Barry?
Barry's on strike today.
Oh, wow.
Slashed out by the producers. So we aren't on strike.
Trying to think which bit of the route it is where I'm scared.
I think it should be now.
There's a bit, I think you might actually be coming up to it. Where literally you're just literally on a cliff face over the valley and it's terrifying.
Oh yeah.
I don't even know where. I mean, I've heard it mentioned before, but I don't know where Linda's Leap is.
Oh, that's it.
Why is it called Linda's Leap?
In fact, am I going past it now? No, I don't think so.
Logan, do you know the Thomas story of
Bulldog?
Bulldog.
Oh, did Falcon Linda Durant. Do that?
Yeah, Linda fell off the track.
Yeah, that was what happened to Linda.
I'm like, dang.
Ah! Guys, there's a big deep cliff and it's really far down!
Tom, ah! Fine, Tom.
Tom, jump it.
Don't look down.
Fucking jump it.
No!
Just get some running speed and just jump it.
It's the fact that we've got the three types of friends here. We've got Luke trying to be the sympathetic one, me being throw some balls, and Chris going, jump it. Jump it, you'll be right.
You'll be fine, Tom. Just hold
right, I'm
on.
I'm not going any faster. I'm not going any faster than 16.
Well, Tom, you should go like 5 miles an hour faster than the speed limit and just tip.
Okay, yeah. Look, good idea. Just go faster than the clip. Just go super fast.
Could you imagine falling down that thing?
Quicker.
You know, just inch by inch.
Could you picture yourself drifting it? Oh, I want to drift it now.
Multi-track
Somebody
drifting.
Wants Tom to crash, but he's not Reese.
Oh boy.
Oh my god! That is so high. I know it's virtual and it's in a game.
It's not even VR.
But it feels so high.
You wanna go and do this in real life then?
At least it's not in virtual reality.
Yeah, I'm not going to the Ffestiniog railway now, it's too scary.
How about you go to Tarthlin instead and stop being a little bitch?
Tarthlin's like flat though, isn't it? And straight for like 7 miles.
No.
Alright, Iva, calm down.
Boom, boom.
Okay, I think the scary cliffs are over with for the time being.
I'm trying to find where the Double Fairlies and stuff is under.
It'd be FP Railways.
Thank you, Tom.
What was I going to do? Oh, yeah, because I can't work out how to get it to work on Thingy Bob. Get the injectors on.
Get the injectors
on. I'm trying to save as much water as I can because I will have to top up at some point.
Super Class 47 on the FNWHR. No.
Tom, imagine going around those corners in the Super 47.
No.
Oh, yes.
You wouldn't even make it around the first corner.
You would.
I'm going to drive my favorite. What was it?
Shit. India's going far and Emirates. China. Fuck. That's far.
So I know they've built a couple of the Ffestiniog engines. Like, it's the Fairlies and Braemar at the minute, isn't it?
The three double, the single, Taliesin, and then Britomart.
And I know, I think they're doing a add-on pack with George England's, aren't they?
They're apparently going to update the pack. So then, like, they can add more things.
I think everybody will be more impressed when they put the George England's. I'd like to see the George England's, Mountaineer, and some of the diesels.
Oh, yes.
To be fair, I wouldn't mind seeing Blanche and Linda.
I think someone's got that covered already, though.
Oh, yeah, him.
Not going to mention the name.
Tom.
Bob Marley.
Oh, shit, that's scary.
You're ready. Don't be happy.
Okay, let's use those. Those
you Tom, David Patterson. David Patterson has asked, any progress on TDRS route?
No.
On the TDRS route.
I think you should give him a slight spoiler.
What, everything's going to explode?
Yeah.
Well, no, it's too late. It's already happened at the junction. Crashed.
What? I didn't do anything.
You're shutting the brake van again.
Hey, listen, alright? No.
We told you we were keeping the nukes in there. But no. Someone couldn't hold it to the toilet again.
Next time, go find a bush.
Now, the thing is the toilets are literally only on the other side of the museum. He chooses not to go in them on purpose.
Because he's a little bitch.
Holy shit.
I've just realised how big the coaches on Ffestiniog are compared to Taliesin coaches.
I know, right? They're well wide.
No, it's... I'm not even talking about wide, I'm talking about lengthways. So I've placed them down at Cowan Wharf. And where I could get like five or six coaches in at the platform at the wharf, I can only get three of them in.
Huh.
I'm like, bruh, I need help. And there's a random black five that just pulls in and goes, yo.
Thanks, Chris, you've upset Gareth.
What number is it? 45440. Oh, it's Stan!
How's Chris upset Gareth?
He restored the brake van.
Oh.
God damn it, Chris.
Parody Murray is clearly excited that you had the Ffestiniog.
I think he's masturbating into it.
Chris.
Did you do a heart crash?
Yes, he did.
Are you trying to build bridges of where you've already destroyed them?
No, I'm trying to burn them down even further by pissing Gareth off. I'm trying to destroy the foundation that we're supposed to build on, even this, the
guys,
cliffs that we're built to go over. Yes.
There's a really big fucking dam coming up.
Or can you jump off it?
No.
Why not, Tom? It'd be fine.
How
oh, God,
bad.
That's not scary as the cliffs, it's fine.
Oh, God, oh, it's not scary as the cliffs, it's fine. Tom's logic, you like. Right, I need to shun Delgo out of the way.
Bloody hell, that is a tall thing.
Yeah, I was thinking about going to Ffestiniog. Now I'm trying to just go, like, fuck that.
Just fuck it. I ain't doing one with it.
Andrew, the question is, which is worse, Ffestiniog or Snowdon Mountain?
I was thinking of Snowdon Mountain when I was 10. And it's a nice ride up, except for the coaches. Because when I went here, it still had the wooden enclosed coaches, instead of those new modern ones.
Yeah, they have got the new ones, haven't they?
And, yeah. But the old ones, I hated them. Because as you went up, they would rock because of the wind. And they didn't seal properly. So you had really cold air coming through under the doors. So it felt like, and you could feel the coach body moving slightly. So you're like, oh my god, we're gonna die. Shit, we're gonna die.
No, why are you still alive?
Because somehow God decided that he wanted to keep me on this cruel, cruel earth for another few years.
Oh, that's a shame.
I know, right? And why did he do that?
I mean, he doesn't like you apparently.
As for the suggestion I'm seeing of an electrical fence for Gareth's brake van project,
I will point out that I will be going for a short break once I get to Port Madoc.
Awesome.
I'll probably disappear off then. Because I have to go make food and then I'm going out with a girlfriend.
Ha ha! You pretend you've got a girlfriend. Is it actually a female cousin of yours that you've just bribed?
No, my name's not Anthony or Gareth or Chris or any of
them. Hey! Cheeky little fuck.
You've known me for at least a year. You should have known this already.
And 31 people just heard that.
And I'm about to kick some dig cock 14-year-old minor ass.
15-and-a-half-year-old. Get it right before you start planning your deaths.
Hey, Logan.
Yes, bitch?
Question for you.
What, bitch?
How did that support coach ride go?
You little bastard!
Hey, you fucking
asshole.
Everyone,
calm down.
You asked for that.
Anyway, you asked your cousins in bed.
Let's go back to child friendliness.
No, we're not PC.
So, right, we're not PC.
Political correctness, what's that?
Fuck PC.
We're not police officers.
I can't say anything because the police are digging into me while stuff's going on.
Oh, are they now? How mainly, does it hurt?
This is mainly because of when I was talking about when I got threatened on the train for no reason.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, this is fine, because they don't know who the dude is and they need people to, like, spread the word. If you know a dude with a shitty mustache who tried to threaten kids on the train when they're in first class, call me!
I agree with you, Seb, 100%.
What did he say?
I'm not gonna say it because I want Logan to figure it out himself.
Oh. Is it that Logan's a big fat cunt, a big fat cunt, a big fat
Seb,
cunt Nathaniel?
Seb! That too. At least I'm allowed to play actual trains instead of shitty little electric trams.
Youch.
Ow.
Youch.
Meow.
You need to fucking get the flamethrower yet, Logan.
I've turned into my
brother. I know you want the flamethrower, but this is not a brony convention. You don't need the flamethrower.
You know what? It's really strange for driving this route.
What?
I didn't ever think the Ffestiniog was like this hilly or this mountainous. I didn't honestly think it was. And now that I've driven it in the game, I've realised how actually hilly and twisty and turny it is. I thought it was more like the Tal of Flynn, like straight line. But it's actually like, you know... Logan, can you stop masturbating, please?
I just whacked my thumb on my desk.
Big wolf cropper, you big, mature 15-and-a-half-year-old.
I scraped the skin off my finger and it really hurts.
Aww.
Okay, that... Okay, that is painful.
Yes, you utter bitch.
That must have been painful. Bonk.
There's lots of whistling required on this route.
Yes,
because
of course.
It's
you can blame
Wales.
My whistle.
I mean,
it's Wales. And
Chris, you might want to go take a look at what Gareth put.
Ooh.
I can't look at the live stream chat.
Sharpens the blade. Chris, you're next.
Where?
Yeah, Gareth.
Yeah, Gareth, he's going to come after your throat in a bit.
This is actually a quite nice looking route, though.
Speaking of Gareth.
Oh, shit. Oh, hello.
Bonk, 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 bonk.
Yes.
I have a feeling that Gareth may have been in the middle of something then.
Doing what?
Hey, Gareth, how you doing?
Again?
I'm not like you, Logan. I don't need to.
He just opened the brony tab and then we pulled him in and was like, oh, shit.
Chris, don't.
No, not now.
I said, that's next week, Chris. Get your fat
for
it. He admitted to it!
Right. Anyways, Tom, what do you think is the most beautiful part of the route so far?
And so Chris couldn't form a proper sentence again.
I don't really have a favorite bit, to be honest, at the moment.
Racist.
Oh.
How's that racist?
Because you're Welsh.
I'd probably say Tom's favorite bit would probably be the cliffs.
Yes, the cliffs. Very much the cliffs.
What, Cliff Burton?
That bald damn.
Say, Chris. I do like the fact that the coaches come with passenger versions and non-passenger variants.
Well, for empty stock movements, innit? Because most of the time,
yeah,
you need like empty stock to, you know, be empty and stock.
True. Yeah, because like, it's like weird because you can have like Mark 1s sat in the sidings, like, oh look, they've already got passengers in, but they haven't gone to the station yet. Who gives a fuck? This is logic.
Up north, we and Southquays just went to war.
What?
I know in my game.
Oh, I was going to say, don't say things like that.
No.
Get Tom into trouble again.
Me and my game, that's what I'm for.
Might acquire this route somehow at some point. And look at Seb up there, all alone. Poor Seb.
What, is he sat in the chat?
Well, I'm sorry, Chris, but before you consider, remember what happened last time. He gets very loud very quickly on a live stream, so yeah. I'm afraid
sorry,
that's...
Seb, you're not allowed in.
Fucking be nice to the guy, but fair enough.
Yeah.
Also, for the guys playing Plymouth Roadrunner, yes, good boys, I have one of those, actually.
Ooh.
Wait, hang on, which one was the one that looks like pretty much like the one that they used to copy the Dodge Charger Daytona? Because I know there's one that Dodge pretty much copied for the Daytona.
Wait,
the Dodge Charger Daytona came out before the Plymouth Superbird.
Exactly.
So Plymouth copied.
They're owned by the same company.
Copied. Yeah, they're owned by the same. They were owned by the same Chrysler.
They're owned by Chrysler.
Yeah,
they weren't competing against each other. They were competing against things like the Mercury Cyclone Spoiler 2.
Yeah.
And the Talladega.
No masturbating in the chat, Gareth, we told you already.
That's your job, Logan.
It's not his job, per se, but it's something he does.
Yeah,
is there a location to get water? At Port Maddock, yes.
Location doesn't like cars. You must be confused.
Oh, I remember
me
7 the lot, and Callum did one of those.
Guys, I'm a terrorist. I just hijacked something.
What did you hijack? The Fred?
You want to know something, Chris?
No.
The moment you said that... Chris, you want to know
the question
what
is,
just happened?
Where are you going to stop? Because if you stop there, then when you come out of the break, you're going to have to reverse out.
Yeah, so I'd have to reverse out anyway to continue up to the Welsh Highland.
That's true.
So basically what I'll do is I'll go down... I'll go into the station, get water, and then I'll head off. I'll reverse out and then head up the Welsh Highland.
Lovely jabbling.
Now, the question is, though, do we think this single Double Fairlie will be able to handle all the coaching going up the Welsh Highland? I imagine so.
Yeah, it'll be a challenge.
I think we could be more confident with a single Double Triple.
Well, I could have double headed, but I didn't think about that.
Do you reckon we'll see this guy's OD the Welsh Island Garrett? So
it'd be nice to think so, wouldn't it? Right, the good news is I'm glad that we're getting towards Port Maddock because I need a wee and a fag.
Well, I'm gonna move. Oh.
So because I think we're at Boston Lodge now.
I have no idea where anything is on the Ffestiniog Railway. I thought Boston Lodge and Port Maddock was where we started.
No, we started at Blaenau Ffestiniog. Or Blaenau, however you pronounce it. Sorry, Welsh people, I can't speak your language!
Blaenau Ffestiniog, where the slate quarries were.
We're coming. Well, what we're doing now is onto the famous cob, which is basically looks like to me like a drag strip, which is why I'm going to go really fast over it. Oh, you're joking.
What?
They don't go fast.
They go like 19 something.
Hey, look, can we go into the workshop? I want to see what the replica Welsh pony is getting on.
It's being Welsh.
Pony? Someone say pony. Get Gareth out of here.
Isn't there a real version?
What?
What's this about ponies?
Isn't there a real Welsh pony, like? Or is it just a replica?
Didn't I call it the replica Welsh pony, Logan, because of how much they've replaced.
They've replaced pretty much the entire engine.
Oh, just like the replica A3.
No.
Pretty much.
I can't remember what the actual feces is, but it's some. There's a paradox. Like some, I think it's like feces is ship.
Yeah.
Something like that. Which is, if you had an old boat, and you replaced one plank in it, eventually you had to replace every other plank in the ship. Now, after what time does that ship become a different ship, or is it still the same boat? Even if it's had its timber replaced.
I think Tom may. I think Tom
does anyone know what Tom's saying?
Yeah.
No idea.
It's a theory of a or some sort of thing where.
Oh, did I cut out again?
Someone didn't reply to.
No, it's just we have no idea like what that means.
Right. Basically, if you replace, how long is it? When you replace parts on a machine until it's no longer the same machine that it originally was. So, for example, with Welsh pony...
I guess...
It's a paradox, mate. It's a paradox.
Oh, I get it now.
So, like, you know, like, let's say, for example, you've got Welsh pony. Let's say you replace the saddle tank, you replace the smoke box eventually, you replace... like bits of bobs and metal on the frames and whatnot. How long is it until it's no longer the original?
True.
I'd say until the frames get replaced, because I say frames are the base of the engine.
But the frames have been replaced.
Then it's a replica, I'd say.
Well, the thing I put into it is that the fact that it's all been replaced at once, obviously with most machines, obviously you replace parts over a period of time. But with Welsh pony, they've obviously like done all these like major replacements in one go.
They probably think it'll be economical like that.
It's a bit confusing though why they chose it, decided they wanted to restore it. Though that's the thing.
That's very true.
Mind you, apparently they want to keep Princess in that condition, so.
Right, fellas, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to stop the train at the station. I'm going to put my intermission screen up and let you lot talk while I go for a cigarette. Like, obviously, people will still be able to...
now.
All right, then, Logan. So what I'll do is I'll keep the... Obviously, people can listen to the chat that you guys are doing while I'm gone. But... in the meantime, I'm going to mute myself on there. And what are we going to do?
Okay. Fag.
Yeah, we're going to put this image up. So we'll be back shortly for the second half of this run.
Can we pop in Spooners first?
Yeah, sure. I'll pop us into Spooners first. Hold on.
I just realised, is this like an old version? Is this some like set a couple of years ago? Oh, then, because it's obviously before they replaced those tracks with a platform.
Actually, no.
Yeah. Maybe they're Spooners. That's Spooner's bar.
Anyway. Princess inside.
No. Anyway, I'm going to put the intermission back up. I'll be back shortly.
Right.
And with that, guys, I need to go and prepare because my cousin got engaged. So I have to go to...
All right, bye.
Good luck, kid.
I need luck when I'm going to see family. I'll see you guys soon.
Goodbye. Adios.
Alright,
so you that airplane for everyone.
If Logan's gone, do we want to bring Seven?
Are you sure you want to do that?
I say yes. Fuck yeah, Seven's a nice guy.
Alright, actually, yeah. But the thing is, though, will he be loud?
Well, we all are fucking loud, so let's not single him out just because you feel like he's loud. Hi, Seb.
Hello, Seb.
Also, just gonna real quick say this, since this is an intermission, to everyone watching, make sure you go and give some money, if you have any spare, to Tom's Patreon account. He really needs it. And then we can get that computer going.
Oh, yes.
Which means,
and while you do that, support every... Also, to everyone out there, if you have some money, support every content creator, because they all need it, because YouTube is a fucking bitch.
Ah.
So, yeah. Help.
And there's also one more thing I want to say. If you want good content, subscribe to Epic Banastard on YouTube.
Oh, fuck off.
If you want good content...
And suddenly, bing, one more subscriber.
Yeah.
This Dark DJ Productions live stream is sponsored by literally nothing.
Yeah. No, I usually just say that in case, you know, people want to subscribe just for the fun of it.
So you go open the hearts of wallets and give you a bit of money.
No, I don't want any money. I just think that if people want to see more of us lads, including Tom, because he joins in on some races sometimes, they can go over to my channel because I record some races here and there and some duck game and some golf.
Oh, I know something. I have an advertisement. Pretty much, if you want fun, if you want World War II things and you want to shoot people down, play War Thunder.
Nah, yes, worth
the shit. Advertisement time, boys, for your advertisements.
This is also a public service announcement to all members of the Dart DJ Productions Facebook group. Tom is going away, Ian, this week, so me, myself, and Chris are your new overlords.
Yes, you will bow to our commands, and we shall post random shit.
They're going to rule with an iron fist.
Actually, I'm actually going to test that, see if Tom will realize if we post anything.
You know, you can't just look back at the video, Chris.
Oh yeah, I know. But I'm just going to say, while Tom's gone, me and Anthony have, and then post a picture of Palpatine saying unlimited power.
This is gonna go horribly wrong. That's
you don't even know, Gareth.
fuck. Well, what kind of world have I opened?
I have a feeling someone just messaged me.
Oh, it's just Seb. Seb saying I'm mute because I'm lap. Oh no! Come on, Seb.
No, Seb. No.
You are too
bad boy.
We are all loud. Don't do that.
Mike.
Oh, wow, Seb. So... Oh, thank God, he's back. Oh, no, he's still muted because, like, he's loud.
Turn your mic on this instant, young man.
Turn around.
Don't tempt him.
To be fair,
don't
he
fucking
is doing
tempt
homework,
him,
lads. And Luke.
Wow. What?
Shut the fuck up.
Okay.
Also, for those of you who didn't know, I'm playing Star Wars Battlefront 2 at the moment.
This is good for him. He sounds like he's having fun.
I am having fun. Yeah, we basically agreed, George, that Anthony will be Owen and I'll be Ryan. Because Anthony will go mad with power and I will just be there like, I don't know what to do here.
Chris, that means you could be anyone fine by the end of the week. You do know that, right?
No, because Ryan didn't kill Owen. It was Leanne.
Yeah.
But you both ended up dying by the end of the week. So who's going to take over from you then?
Right, we have to pick then. Who's going to be Leanne / Repulse? Fuck.
Who's the biggest female here? Oh yeah, Gareth!
Aha!
Hi, Seb.
Bastard.
Well, there's all out, man.
Hey, Seb. You're louder.
Oh.
We are very abusive.
Yes, we all know this. I can remember... fuck.
English Gareth, not brony talk.
Hey!
Mm-hmm.
Hey!
I make Elizabeth II the Queen of England, because I can. Time to restore the British Empire.
Mm-hmm. Do you want to say that I died in Doctor's file?
No, you're wrong there. It's time to... reinstate the Viking Empire, which means I'm coming for your booty, Chris.
Oh, please don't.
Oh, I see a log. Cut him above.
Master Sif, there are too many things. What shall we do?
Well, I'm gonna say, Seb. Unfortunately, due to the Dark Lord himself saying it, we're not allowed to reference Star Wars too much.
Do we bring Callum in?
Well, he's not here.
Screw it. In comes the Mr. Hancock.
Can someone drag him?
Hello.
Oh, it's Callum.
Hello.
It's the seat. I mean,
it's a cheese head.
Hey.
I stopped myself.
I'm happy. I've got pizza.
Oh, you got us a pizza. Nice.
Anyone gonna ask me what sort of pizza it is?
The one they made a tower.
What type of pizza is it?
It is lamb bolognese.
Bolognese.
Hello.
Hello, Tom.
Oh, hello, Callum. I didn't realise you dropped in to say hi.
Hi.
Yeah, he got dragged in.
Anyway.
Hi.
Shall we continue with our little journey?
No.
Go on.
What do you mean,
I'm
no?
I'm spilling spooners.
Right, well, I'm just going to get some water, Anthony. I'll move the coaches back into the station. Are you still ordering your food, you fat bastard?
No, I'm just, like, staring at this blank space where there used to be a train here.
Oh. Speak of that.
Actually, does anyone know if there's, something on display in Spooners at the minute?
Yep.
Charlie Grammer says, "Oi, you mugs, turn down the shouting." Oh, I had the volume up. Excuse me.
I've got to remember where I put water in on this thing.
Are you guys, on the Ffestiniog?
We've already done the Ffestiniog. We're now about to go onto the Welsh Highland.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, here we go. Getting water, lads.
Hey, look, it's a bear. I see, like, a yellow bear with a scarf tied round its face.
Do you?
Lions, tigers, and bears, oh my.
Hi, Pudsey. Fuck off, I'm Paddington, he said.
Talking of charity.
Oh, here we go.
My dad is trying to get us a charity license so we can go to the Birmingham German market to do some fundraising.
Right.
So that's going to be fun. A bunch of furries in the German market going, "Give us your money." That's going to be fantastic.
Oh, we've lost Seb.
Oh, poor pastries.
Last night,
he's just
Seb,
pastry.
Daniel, and Freddy were lost in the giant muffin.
By the way, if anyone's wondering why I'm still sat at the water pump, it's because I'm injecting until I get to 100%, they're going to refill the tanks again. So I've got maximum range, so hopefully I ain't got to stop again until I get to the Caernarfon.
Tom, are you streaming?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh. Why do you think we're up here?
Why?
So if I were you, Callum, I'd go and help out on moderating the chat for me. Because you know what it's like, every time you get here, it's question time.
Oh, shit. Here we go.
Well, it's not our job to look at the chat and ask questions, Tom. You know you assigned that role to Mr. Hancock.
Oh, also, I will say that I am fairly sure that this is fairly patent.
I will say, to you plebs who are watching the live stream, right? If there's anything about Austin ambassadors and wide regs, it will not be read out because that's been done to death.
Said the guy who invented it.
Yes.
Anyway, Anthony, we're leaving now, so.
Alright, it's alright. I'm almost done. I'm just breaking this engine out. Come on, princess, we're going home.
She is home.
Break your engine out for the life.
No spray down a wall last time. She'll break down one. Yeah,
there's just a random guy sat on the wall at the side for Port Maddox. It's really strange. He's just drinking a cup of tea, watching the train go by.
Huh. Alright.
You know what, I tell you what, even though I like these models, don't get me wrong, of these coaches and engines, I mean, but I do see that they do look a bit like MSTS converts. I know they're not, but it's that kind of sort of grainy quality. I'm not saying I don't like them, it's just that's what I've noticed. Also, I must admit, I do like this observation car. It's very nice to have one.
I know what you're on about, Tom, because, what's it, the Stania Mogul has the same look, doesn't it?
Yeah. No problem. Right, we've now reversed that Porthmadog. Let's head towards the mountains and go up the Aberglasian Pass.
Wait, isn't the Stania Mogul an MSTS convert, though? Because it's a Kevin Martin engine, isn't it?
Yeah, but it's not a convert.
Really?
No.
James Wright, I've told you!
And so James Wright died because of Callum.
The end.
Is there trains convert?
Right.
No, that's the...
Guys, we're going to head over to Britannia Bridge. We're going to do this.
Are we going to rule Britannia?
Yes.
Oh, shit!
Whoa, Britannia.
Nothing. Power.
Hang on, is that how you get onto the Welsh Island? Is it literally just reverse out the station and go up that loop?
Yeah. You basically come out of the station, and then you go across the Britannia Bridge.
So basically, they touch the left stick to turn the right one.
Speaking of Fairlies again.
Hold up a sec. Yeah, that's right, you fucking car. You fucking wait for me, you cunt. I'm coming across this but level crossing. Screw you. Anyway, carry on, what?
Oh, I don't want to wait for you. You're a grotty little Welsh thing.
Go finger yourself.
Right, Turbo.
Designed by a Scotsman as well.
You were designed by a Scotsman.
Mr. Wright, not for much longer.
What are you complaining about, what's James doing?
Well, James Wright, he's just put in, I'm still alive, Callum. I'm saying, not for much longer, you're not.
Well, what's he done?
Everything.
Jesus Christ, give a concrete answer.
He's done everything. He's a sex. He's obsessed with sex. He's Quagmire.
No, he's obsessed. He's obsessed with Norway, but that different matter.
Yeah, but Chris, we all know he's about to get down on one knee any day now.
Yeah, we know. That's how much he loves Norway.
Well, hopefully Denmark.
I was about to pull a really, really bad one there. I'm not gonna.
But again, just going back to Fairlies again. Who is seeing Livingston Thompson at the NRM?
I have.
That's the fourth one, isn't it?
It's the one that said the NRM, yeah.
Has it been gifted to the NRM, or is it just on loan?
It's just on loan, I think. I've not seen it.
Oh, by the way, I would like to point out, because we'll be going past it in a minute, I can't be the only one who's noticed that the Welsh Highland Heritage Railway, which is the short bit, right, it's literally pointless. It is literally, why bother? Mm-hmm. Because if I show you guys on the map, literally, we're on this railway. The Welsh Highland Heritage Railway literally runs from this bit here, which where it says WHRR port, and it literally just runs parallel with the Welsh Highland Heritage Railway, Welsh Highland Railway to there. I mean, why? That is not a preserved railway. That's just tiny and pointless.
That's what she said.
We get to cross the main line. We get to cross Standard Gauge Railway in a minute.
I think, hold on, is the Welsh Highland Heritage a different gauge?
No, it's the same gauge.
Well, exactly, what's the fucking point of it then?
There isn't.
That's what we're getting at.
There we go.
I wouldn't mind seeing Russell for it, though.
Yeah, that would be cool. Anyway, crossing Standard Gauge, hello!
Hi.
We kind of stopped on Standard Gauge. Quick! We've got to get out of here, there might be a train coming! Crap! Help me.
We hear a distant Super 47 horn.
Oh my god, run away!
2 seconds later, bang!
Anyway, now I'm in this view. Here's the extent of the Welsh Highland Heritage Railway. There's the station there. For it. It goes along here. It goes up here. And that's the end. That's it. At Penny Mount.
I think I know why the Welsh Highland Heritage Railway is there.
enlighten us with your knowledge, Mr. Callum.
To make more money.
Callum figured it out, boys.
No. Basically, what it was, the Welsh Highland Heritage Railway from what I can gather, they were a group of volunteers from the Ffestiniog who got annoyed with the management, so they decided to set their own railway up on the Welsh Highland. But when the Ffestiniog announced their plans to rebuild the entirety of the West Highland Railway, they came up with an agreement of some sort that they could have that bit, like that little bit there. It's a bit strange, but still.
But basically, what you're saying is that the Welsh Highland Heritage Railway is like a particular part of the Trainson community that starts with R and ends with G.
Rosenglag.
Yeah, that's it. The rest of the Ffestiniog and the Welsh Highland Railway is basically
the wider community.
The what?
The wider community.
Oh, I don't bash.
It's like the DDJP and AWP.
My breaking news.
I was about to fucking do that.
It's my penis.
It's my penis.
Head to the mountain, boys.
Oh
god, I'm gonna burp.
We're talking Brokeback Mountain.
Oh no.
Weirdly enough, I've never seen that film.
Why is that weird?
Think about it.
Oh, yeah, right. Never mind.
Yeah. Exactly, Chris. Your brain had to engage there for a
Listen,
second.
Listen, Callum, I'm tired, alright?
No, you're not, young lady.
Bitch, the fuck did you say?
Your name's Chris.
He's deaf as well.
Excuse me?
Oh, you offended him?
I've got a good feeling this part of the journey is going to take a lot longer because here's what we've covered so far, and it's taken me nearly an hour. That is what we still have to cover.
Well,
and we're at reduced speed. Because Fairly doesn't go any faster than 18 on the flat.
Wow, really?
Yep.
I thought they went a bit faster than that.
Not in the simulation, anyway.
No.
Just like the simulations.
Well,
Oh, well, at least we can look at the scenery going by from the train. That's what this live stream was all about, anyway.
Yay!
That is one long hit. That is quite long, Jesus.
Crazy.
That's what he said last Friday.
Oh, fuck off.
No, that's really what he said last week.
We have fun here.
So, I'm going to field this question out. Because I mentioned it in my vlog. No, it's not the thing you guys think I'm going to mention, because we'll talk about that later.
Okay.
This whole thing with Patreon. You guys, I don't know how many of you guys here are actually patrons at present. Probably none of you. Are you a current patron, Chris?
Shit, never mind.
You're not. To current patrons and past patrons, anyway, I just need to ask the question if they're watching the stream as well, or if there's anyone who's actually considering joining my Patreon thing. How many people would actually continue paying into Patreon knowing that I've now pretty much got the amount for the base of the computer? Because the reason I ask is just that I'm not bothered if people don't. I'm just curious to see how many people would want to still help me out a bit.
While we're waiting for the replies to that part, we've got a
like
very
to help still.
Bit of trivia here.
Okay.
George Quayle, I think it is, says, in real life, the speedo on Madden Imres goes up to 70 miles an hour.
Excuse me.
I'm pretty sure that Double Fairlies can't go up to 70 miles an hour.
It'd be fun trying it, though.
Well, actually, Kellen, this brings me back to a funky point. Yes?
Tom, kick it into full gear.
No.
I want to see this.
We came back to an interesting point we came up with earlier, Callum. Hmm. A standard gauge Double Fairlie.
I think they exist.
Do what? They?
I think so. Let me have a little look see.
Because I'm pretty
are
sure
you
that I'm pretty sure that Double Fairlies are exclusive to narrow gauge. I know you've got. I know you've got. Is it the mayor? That could technically be considered a. No, it isn't. That's not a double fairly.
Malay technically is.
Parley.
Oh bugger.
Oh shit.
Oh shit.
I'll just go to the best place to do our research, Wikipedia, lol. Apparently, there's actually thousands and thousands of fairies technically running around in the world.
Is there?
Yes. Diesels and electrics.
You're funny.
You're funny, Will, I say.
It literally says it, though. While the fairly locomotives are used only on heritage railways, the vast majority of diesel and electric locomotives in the world today follow a form not very different from the fairly. Two power trucks of all axles driven, and many also follow the fairly's double-ended concept, being capable of being driving equally well in both directions.
That's basically like a tank engine, though. So does that make the leader a fairly?
Yes.
What the hell is this, Callum?
That is a standard gauge double fairly, and if you look, it does actually say Fairlie's patent on the side tank, because of course, Robert Francis Fairlie, was it? He was a bit of a showboater. He really loved showing off the double fairlies, and even tried selling the idea to the Americans for the Rio Grande. But the locomotives couldn't carry enough coal for the whole run.
So, where was this built?
Was that built? I just found a picture of mine. So I don't know where it's. I think it's Russia. I don't know.
Well done, Callum. Well done.
You made yourself look like a cat. Got...
I found a picture. Okay, that's all I was asked to do. I got my end of the bargain.
Anyway, did we ever get any answer to that question I asked? Especially you guys who are actually in this chat, because that's you're the people I'm actually asking at first.
What chat?
This one.
Yeah, as in what we're doing, like as in the people who are talking to me right now.
Once I start earning money, people. I will.
What, Chris?
Once I start earning money properly, I will donate to you every month.
What, even though, what I'm asking is even though I've basically got the money ready for the computer.
Yeah.
Yes.
I would.
Same here.
Interesting. Anyone else here? I mean, even one of you guys that aren't, even if you guys aren't currently patrons?
If I win the lottery, I'll give you £6,000.
That it?
You... Wow!
I'm a very good one.
Wow!
Greedy. That's it. I was going stingy, but that's the polar opposite.
Right, folks. I've done some research on that particular example.
Callum, you know we've moved on, right?
Yeah.
And I plus want to know what you think
about the Patreon thingy.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's probably worth giving over a little bit of money for basically to support the series. I mean, let's face it, there are a lot of people out there who do Patreon campaigns, but a lot of people do it for the sake of asking for money. You don't actually do it for the sake of asking for money, because it's not like
it's not like I'm basically turning around saying, oh, so I can quit my job and so I can pay my rent with you lot paying my rent for me. It's not like I'm doing that. No. I work a nearly full-time job in order to pay my rent and bills. Mm. So.
Yes. I reckon you're still a worthy cause.
Like, who keeps popping in and out? Can they stop it?
Gareth dropped out.
If people keep dropping out, I'm going to start telling people to stay dropped out.
I did it once because the computer was playing out a bit.
That's because you're ugly. What?
Anyway,
carry on, Callum.
Yeah, I reckon you're still a worthy cause. Even once the computer's bought, paid for and everything, I still reckon you're a worthy cause for support. Because, of course, there are all sorts of other things you possibly do for the channel. I'm not going to state any of them, but... You'll have loads of ideas, I'm sure.
Well, there's there's that idea I popped up with well, Callum, which was that I think this new patron, Hugh, I can't remember the last name off the top of my head, Hugh something. I said about in the vlog about the possibility of covering different DLCs if the patrons maybe wanted to help pay for them if they wanted to. And this guy seemed interested in that, and Hugh has actually become a patron, and he's pledging $5 a month now. So clearly that means that at some point I'm going to have to buy some DLC that he requests, which would be nice. And I'll cover it in the Dark Tries. So yeah, that's an interesting cause. If other people want to do that, they can. But remember, it's people's choice. I'm not going to force anyone to do anything.
So effectively, for the purpose of Dark Tries, basically.
Essentially, yeah. Like if there's a piece of DLC that I haven't really got any interest in purchasing personally myself, then if patrons all agreed, or if say a person donated a certain amount and agreed that I would purchase a certain DLC to cover for them, then I can't I? If that makes sense.
Yeah,
that's feasible.
I mean, like, the thing is as well, though, I'd have to make sure that all patrons are sort of happy with that, so I'm hoping if any patrons are actually watching this right now, what do they think of that concept? Or if they're on the Discord chat, what do they think of that concept? Because I think it's an interesting concept, but I don't know, I don't want to feel like I'm just sort of like begging people for money so I can buy fancy DLC, because it'd be what people choose me to buy, basically, unless I've already got it, of course.
It's basically the idea is purchasing it for a review. But
it's for sort of entertainment purposes for everybody, I guess, so it still comes under the category of it being donated still for the channel, but we're just being a bit... It's a bit like the computer fund, actually, isn't it, thinking about it?
I mean, it's also like what Mr. Eden Green is doing with Team Locos and Profile, which is he's basically charging, so that means you've got more content, basically, the whole concept. The only thing is that Mr. Eden Green doesn't put it in a very good way. You know, so, yeah.
Oh, Callum, speaking of Christine Green, what did you make of you've seen his latest video, haven't you? The soul slip on the D.
Yeah.
What did you make of how he ended that video?
I can't remember.
He said, like, oh, it's one of the only Starfish and Chester mentions that hasn't run yet.
To be fair, that sounds like something he said before.
It's to be honest, as soon as he said that, I was like, where is it? The National Railway Museum, where engines go to die. It's never
not necessarily, Callum.
T3
is only going to be steamable because the NRM decided they didn't want it anymore.
Yeah, anyway, exactly. it's not necessarily, because I'm pretty sure in the future that certain engines will get a reprieve. I'd imagine it will probably be something like, you know what, I don't get though. I've never seen them sort of make an active thing for the Class 31. I know we got a lot of 31s in Prez.
But it's a pioneer of the class.
And I can understand the Evening Star.
Yeah, but what else? Is the Q1 steamable?
It's not steamable at the minute. It could be.
The Lanky Tank.
I'd love to see the Lanky Tank work.
Yeah. Please, NRM, let the East Langs have it, Plox.
No!
The Wanky Tank.
Yeah, the Wanky Lanky Tank.
Wouldn't it be ironic if they give out the Lanky Tank and they give it to something like Didcot?
They wouldn't give it to Didcot.
Nah, that would be a punch.
East Lancashire would probably be most appropriate, to be honest.
Yeah, I know, but...
Worth Valley.
Or Worth Valley.
I don't have Logan for that.
Although I will point out, I am quite amused that... Wow. I am quite amused that Keighley and Worth Valley are losing City of Wells.
It's ours now.
Anthony, you bastard, can you give it to me, please?
What?
I want the volcano, please. I want it back in the southern region where it belongs!
Nope, see, Wells has officially revoked its southern citizenship. It's now a proper northern bully.
To be fair, it spent most of its preservation life in the north, hasn't it? It probably it spent more time up north than it did down in the south in BR service.
great, lovely geezel.
So, I've got one idea for TDRM.
Although we have gone off the original topic, because I didn't know if anyone actually answered in the chat about what I was talking about. In the actual...
I didn't see anything.
I don't trust the NRM anymore. George Cronin. I see where you're coming from.
I've seen a few people say that they think it's okay if you do that, Tom.
Yeah, well, it's like, I don't know, it's a really weird situation at the moment because, like, I like having patrons because it sort of gives me people that I can show early access to and whatnot. But
yeah, that's another thing you can say, like, they get early access.
I've already said they get early access.
I'm just thinking as well, what we're saying about, like, Northern Bullies. An episode of TDRF. Like, where are you going, Eustace, my brother? Where are you going? I'm going up north, where all of the coal miners live. Oh, all right, Eustace, I'll see you later. 2 weeks pass. All right, Eustace.
Hey, up.
You've changed, Eustace.
No, I bloody haven't. I don't know what you're on about, 257. Barry rolls in. Oh, finally, Eustace sounds normal.
What?
Oh god, guess what?
What?
Oh. Hi, Lamb.
You fucking pig.
The chat.
Tom, how could you?
Wait, no, what?
Oh, Callum, no. Right, I'm not gonna say. Oh,
fuck's sake.
Chris, what have you said, Chris?
I only said Callum no. Callum yes.
Come on, man.
It'd be funny if you cried come even on. More at being told yes he can.
If I said Callum maybe, I'd confuse the shit out of him.
Yeah,
sound like a fucking what? Monkey.
Sounds like a cat.
We've already suffered from this. We don't know. I was a cat.
Speaking of cats, maybe. Callum, how's Tibble?
Talking about cats.
Anthony, go get my fucking cat.
Fuck off.
Nom.
Holy things.
You know, I could go get him for you, Callum.
No, you can't, because you're Norwegian. Because you're Norwegian and useless.
No, but, you know, cat kebabs are a really delicacy in Norway.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey. I think, if I'm not mistaken, lads, I think I'm in the Aberglasian Pass.
Well, are you going to pass the bill?
No.
No?
I'm going to tell you to shut the fuck up with Chris, fuck Berlin.
Love you too.
Everybody knows a useless humble, Chris.
Well, yeah, we do know you, Callum.
Well, that's true.
Chris,
yes,
listen
love.
To the words that come out of my mouth. We all know a useless cunt called Chris.
Oh, I heard we all know a useless cunt, and he got out. And besides, Callum, I'm not sure if that's your mouth or your asshole talking.
I'm just saying the same to you, fuckface.
Oh, shit.
I presume the stream's going alright then, as usual.
Yes, it's going alright. Just a bunch of people in the chat talking.
No, I meant, like, the actual video.
Yeah, it's going fine.
Alright.
Cool. And I think we're in the Aberglasian Pass. This is interesting. There's a tunnel! Oh my goodness. What am I going to do?
How's the audio on the stream? I have noticed a lot recently with a lot of the stream. For some reason, the audio goes really out of whack with the video.
Mm-hmm. Oh, shit.
How the fuck am I supposed to
do this? Unless that with the duck game coverage, I don't think it really matters too much when we're doing train simulator stuff. With the duck game, it was quite noticeable.
Yeah. I can agree with that.
It went into a tunnel and squeaked for its funnel and never came again.
The engine name was Frank.
Frank.
Hello, my name is Frank.
Frank?
Shut the fuck up.
No!
I thought that was Nick we were supposed to do that to.
Nick's dead.
Yeah, Nick died.
Yeah, Nick being replaced by Chris.
Huh? Sorry, I replaced the main cast, alright.
You are the Nick replacement service.
But, Callum, I don't know what to say. You're supposed to shut the fuck up. Thank you.
Chris. I was getting to it. I was waiting until you shut your fucking mouth.
Jesus Christ, calm down.
Alright, enough of the hostilities.
Hostilities? Was there ever hostilities? I couldn't.
No.
Chris, if you're the Nick replacement service, the next time we do a race, you have to start with your brakes on.
Wait, is that something he did?
It was once, but it was very fun. And it was like one of the first races we ever did.
Oh, really?
What happened again?
Basically, we were racing on the Falmouth Ranch, and as everyone was starting off, we just suddenly hear Nick yelling, "No, why are my brakes on?"
I shall write that down, Cal. Callum? No, Anthony.
Callum? Whoa.
They're both from the north.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Anthony. I didn't mean to insult you.
Wait, what?
You insulted Callum just as much.
Just that one. Wait, what?
Second time today someone's insulted me. My gaffer insulted me today. I sanded down the wheel on a piece of shit Mondeo. And he came over like, "Yeah, dude, you're not too many miles away from it, son. You're not too many miles away from it." I'm like, "I know, I'm quite pleased with that. I'm not completely useless." And as he walked away, he was like, "Well, I wouldn't go that far."
Oh, punch him in the face.
Punch below the belt, mate.
Punch him in the face right now.
He's one of the top, the fucking fat twat. He just fuck all.
Hey. Are you alright?
Yes.
Are you?
Yes. I've got a cigarette. I'm just about to light it, and then everything will be better.
You know what? We'll just summon someone to cool you down. Fetch the Welsh fireman.
The Welsh fireman's currently away.
My lighter. No, my lighter. Where's my lighter gone?
When we fetch Bob, they'll cheer him up.
You lot heard the news though about the Welsh fireman, didn't you, Fireman Sam? It's his birthday today.
Is it?
Oh yeah, it is.
It's what?
Fireman Sam's 30 years old today.
So Fireman Sam came out in 1987. That's quite late. I thought it came out earlier than that.
No, you see it doesn't.
It was 1987, I think.
And it was BBC property.
Sylvester McCoy was the doctor.
How
much further do you gotta go, Tom?
500 miles.
But if you look at the map, we've still got quite a fair ways to go.
In a double fairly, doing 18 miles an hour up a very railway.
Yeah, but I'm loving this. No, don't think I have to stop to take on water either.
I really, really would like to see a Russell model for train sim, but like a half decent one, like a pretty good one.
Can we paint it grey and then call it Fearless Freddy? Ha 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 ha.
You sure not silver?
I was grey.
Oh.
I didn't like Fearless Freddy. I thought he was a twat.
And he thought you were a twat too.
Oh, that's then equal.
Probably.
That's bad.
What the fuck was that?
That was a bad impression of something that will not be mentioned.
Oh.
It could be worse though, Chris, right?
No, I was yawning and then I accidentally sent
it. It could be a little creature that's recently been discovered.
Yes, but I will say I accidentally just sent a Snapchat message to my aunt, flipping her off.
We're at bed.
Oh no.
I think that says bed. I think we're at a place called Bed Jellert, I think it's called. Or Begalert, however you pronounce it, I don't know.
Beth Gellert, which is translated as the Grave of Gellert. And does anyone know the story of Gellert?
Well, I suppose you're going to tell us, though.
Yes, I am.
Once upon a time.
Yeah. Once upon a time in a land.
That's going to be a long story.
Far, far away.
Right. So basically, there was, I think it was either a king or a prince, and he had a baby son. Now, he had to go out and do some fighting for a bit, and left his dog, Gellert, in charge of the baby. While he was away, a wolf snuck in, and Gellert killed the wolf, protecting the baby. When the prince or king or whoever was out fighting, when he came back, he saw all the blood and naturally assumed the worst. And so he killed Gellert, then noticed the dog's, the wolf's corpse, and then thought, oh, whoops, I better name a town after him then. So, of course, Beth Gellert is basically Grave of Gellert.
Huh.
So there you go. It's named after a dead dog.
Charming. Well, at least he did something to recognize the dog.
And that was kind of a handful of story time.
Yeah. I know a lot of Welsh stuff, actually. This is surprising, given that I am Welsh. So...
I mean... you... oh, fuck. Don't you just love having a cold?
Wales, where men are men and sheep live in fear.
Because the men... I won't be mean.
Where is Reese? He'd love this stream.
On a boat, Callum. He's being a pirate still.
I'm saying that because every single time he's on, what's it, Western Lines of Scotland, he goes, oh, it'd be great if Callum was here, wouldn't it? Because he'd love this Reese.
Yeah,
I
remember that.
Seem to recall James yasses after you more than anyone these days, though, during streams.
Don't know why.
Of course.
Yeah, I remember you mentioned the Western Lines of Scotland. I remember that long haul challenge where Reese drove Jeff the Not Thomas engine.
Mm. Yeah, that's like
three
what.
Three people asked for call for you, Callum, and then next thing you know, Bruce is in the stream and he's like, "Has anyone seen Callum lately?"
Mm. I know.
There's just something about you that people want you around if you're not here.
Because I'm
I guess it's because you're funny.
Because he's a spacker.
Yeah, so I love that red paint.
I think it's because I can do voices. I think that's pretty much it.
Yeah, oh yeah, that's probably it, actually. Your baby's, like, incredible.
Don't say
Don't be such a baby, Callum!
Oh, God.
Is that his trigger word now?
Did we have to really go? I'm sorry for saying it in the first place, but did we really have to go? Alright, cool. Stop, thank God. Right.
And on that note, I have to go.
Bye! Oh.
Bye-bye, James.
Bye.
Bye!
You've all lost the game.
Thanks.
Thanks, asshole.
Bruce is blind!
I had to say it since he's out. Not here. Okay, maybe I didn't have to, but I felt like it.
You're not
well, we are evil.
Yeah, how'd you know my secret, Anthony?
You're American, it's in your
car. Oh! You're from Berkshire. Wow.
Well, it's a good thing I'm already leaving.
We subvert these rules in these parts. It's not the Brit that's the bad guy, it's the American.
Oh, well.
Once.
Anyway, I shall talk to you all later.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
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 This is weird.
It's not that weird, trust me, I've said for it.
Oh, Tom?
Mm-hmm?
George Quayle said, I'd refill the tanks again at Beth Gillett if I were you.
Don't need to. I've still got 389 gallons of water.
Then just 10 minutes later, Tom's like stuck on a hill. He ran out of water.
I need to put some water in the boiler.
Put the water in the boiler.
I know that the names of the Double Fairlies all mean something. Like, what was it? Livingston Thompson was a notable... He was, like, one of the founders of the Ffestiniog, wasn't he? Livingston Thompson? And James Spooner was definitely one as well. But what about Madden Imrys? What's Madden Imrys named after?
Well, Emrys means mountain, I think.
Yes, it does.
Well, now we know that.
Hence why I'm naming one of my characters in the future Emrys.
Now, David Lloyd George, that's another one, and that's named after someone.
Helionen? I don't know where that is, but I'm going to stop there so I can fill the tanks. Actually, it might be alright.
Where did it miss?
Wait. Wow. Oh.
Yeah.
Ah, oh, brilliant. That's brilliant.
I imagine Imrys is one of the original Fairlies, because they did build a couple of them. Imagine Imrys, a legendary Welsh wizard who the engine was named after.
Oh.
A Welsh wizard. Basically Merlin with a Welsh accent.
That's pretty wizard.
It says invisibility on.
Invisibility on!
Oh god. Oh no, 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 no.
What's the worst that could happen?
Oh! Merlin Imrys is Merlin.
What, it's just literally Merlin Mountain?
Effectively, yeah.
Holy shit!
Oh, here we go. He called Merlin Ambrosius, which translated in the Welsh means Merdyn Imrys, M-Y-R-D-D-I-N. Livingston Thompson, which is named... He was originally named Taliesin. There's actually nothing on the on my Livingston Thompson was named that way. Then there's David Lloyd George, which is the orange one.
Sorry if I've gone a bit silent. My dad is asleep.
You can't be anointed, son, then.
No!
Wailed the penis.
Alright. David Lloyd George, completed in 1992. After the former Liberal Prime Minister, who's brought up locally and travelled on the Ffestiniog. So, David Lloyd George is named after a politician.
Boring.
James Spooner's obviously named after the pub.
After the pub.
Even if it was a Roddy Stiller name for a pub.
Nothing. Well, I imagine James Spooner is named after one of the founders.
Yeah, I think so. Because James Spooner was actually an original Ffestiniog, but it was scrapped, so this one's technically a replica.
Yeah, he was. James Spooner was involved in the development of the Ffestiniog in the first 20 years of its history.
It's just interesting, though, that they're still building. Fairlies.
Yeah, they've been building Fairlies for the past couple of decades anyway. There's Earl of Merioneth. That one was built in
79.
Well, yeah. Then you got David Lloyd George, which was built for 1992. Taliesin, which was built for 1999. And then you've got James Spooner 2, as it's now known as. Because there was an original engine named James Spooner, but James Spooner 2, that's a new one coming out. So. And of course, they also built Lid as well, didn't they?
Yes, they built Lid.
Yeah.
They also built the bunker, and I think they're also doing the tanks for the Standard 3. You know, the tank.
Oh, Boston Lodge.
Yeah.
Did they?
Yeah, they built the bunker for the Standard 3, and they're doing the tanks as well.
Nice.
I really like Mountaineer. I think that's one of my favourite engines on that line. Oh, originally built for the War Department.
It was originally built as a train.
Oh, originally?
Mm-hmm.
Do you know that?
This is, someone earlier said it would take me about 2 hours to do this. I can see it looking more like three now.
Three what?
Hours.
Yeah. Yikes. Well, we're fucked.
Well, no, not really. I mean, like, to be fair, we've come a long, long way so far. And to be honest, I'm hoping there's a bit of, like, leeway on the gradient, but... I'm going to get beat up again.
Right.
The George Englands don't come with the Ffestiniog, do they?
Not yet.
Because I quite like the George Englands. Quite a charming little engine.
I think everyone does.
The George Englands, it'd be interesting to see what... if they built a replica one in, like, its original form, wouldn't it?
Well, there was talks apparently of doing that to Welsh Pony, weren't there? There are talks about scrapping the Welsh pony they've got and building a new replica of Welsh pony as it would have been delivered.
But well, it's not pointless.
Well, it says that it says on the Ffestipedia that Welsh pony is undergoing a rebuild. So I think they're going to rebuild it into original condition.
No, they're not.
2013 to present, restoration to working order.
No, they're still building it in its like current shape. Come on.
Yeah.
Well, they built a new engine anyway, and they're calling it an overhaul.
I would like them to see to build another engine completely from scratch. Like, I would like to see one of the original North Wales narrow gauge engines, like Beth Gellert, one of the single 064 single Fairlies that operated on there.
Well, like Gowrie.
Yeah, Gowrie would be really interesting because the other two, Moltrifan and Snowden Ranger, they were very similar, those two, but Gowrie was built by Huntsler, so it was a very unique looking engine.
What was so unique about it?
Just the way it looked, really. Because as I said, it was a Hunslet built engine. I'll shove the pictures in the Discord, in the images.
You know what I find interesting when it came to the Welsh narrow gauge engines? I'm very surprised that so few made it into the National Collection, really. I know it's probably because they figured it. Screw it, there's still thousands of them dossing around, but... It's like, can you imagine if you decided they wanted to put one of the Tal Flynn engines in the National Collection or something? Which one would they choose? Do you reckon it'd be Tal Flynn, Dolgoch, or one of the others?
They clearly use Captain Baxter.
Alright, I've shoved the pictures in the Discord for your viewing later, Tom.
Okay, I'll have a quick look now while I'm just shambling along the hill.
Snowden Ranger and Moltrifan definitely look more Victorian than Gowrie, but I've always preferred Gowrie because it's sort of it's kind of like the underdog in some respect.
It looks fucking ugly.
I love Gowrie though. That's the thing. I quite like the ugliness of Gowrie.
Snowden Ranger or Moltrifan, whatever it's called, that looks more like Taliesin.
Yeah. It's basically what it is. It's an 064 version of Taliesin.
Because what's Taliesin? That's an 044, isn't it?
Yeah. Just seen the picture of Russell. Oh, wow.
Yes, Russell.
Russell's a nice engine. I like Russell.
Yeah, it's the colours. Crimson.
Well, I think it's just an overall nice engine.
Scheiße.
Oh. Yeah, it's just
Oh, I'll tell you what though, Callum, I've just been looking at the stock list for the Welsh Highland Railway. It's all, I think it's like literally all but one of their steam engines are Garrett's.
What's the exception?
An NG15.
That's a Garrett, isn't it? Oh, what's an NG15 then?
It's something like... Oh, let's have a look. NG15, it is. Well, they've got two NG15s. They're a group of Mikados.
Oh.
Mr. George Quayle is full of facts, particularly about the Welsh Highland and Ffestiniog. He said there is talk of selling Lid and using the funds to rebuild Mal Tryfan. Its bogey still survives.
Well, you know what I'd say to sell it to then? It'll clearly be sold to Linton and Barnstable.
Yeah.
Because apparently none of them actually like Lid.
But it's a bit out of place, Lid, isn't it? It really.
Yeah. Mm. It kind of makes you wonder why they bother building it.
I think it's because, well, there's very little of Linton and Barnstable left. So, I mean, you've even got the new build Lynn as well. It's currently being built.
It's been built, Callum. It's ready.
Well, it's done.
Oh, yeah, it's done. It's run a couple of times.
Dress? Before I heard Trey said I didn't.
Oh, did you see the picture? Lynn looks so nice.
Did you not know that Lynn exists yet then, Callum?
Well, I knew it was being built, yeah, but I didn't know it had been painted and.
It's been running on the Linton Barnstable. I mean, I need to find out if Linton Barnstable Railway is even running on. I think Tuesday was supposed to be the day.
Mm-hmm.
Someone told me, because I might go there.
Yeah. And see Lynn on in a natural habitat.
Yeah.
Fabulous looking engine. Yeah, I just, as I say though, I like Russell because Russell's just nice. It's just a nice engine. And I think I may be right in saying, though I could be wrong, well, I know for one thing, it's the only original Welsh Highland Railway locomotive that's still in operation.
Are there any others left?
No, don't think so. Because as I say, Beth Gillert was scrapped, as were Mal Tryfan, Snowden.
Have you got a picture of Beth Gillert?
Beth Gillert? Yeah. Oh, it's a big 064 saddle tank.
Nice.
Non-articulated, it's not fairly like a Gary Snowden Ranger or Mal Tryfan.
So I'm just on the lookout to see if Tracy's come downstairs. Trace? So I might have to pause again and go for a cigarette.
Ooh.
No one mind do that?
No.
Let me just stick Beth Gillert in the
alright.
Images.
Here okay. I'll have a quick
look. Oh my god, what? Oh, actually that doesn't look too bad.
Right, I'm gonna pause the game. Pause.
That looks like an elongated Quarry Hunslet.
Basically yes, I what it is.
And I'll be back in a minute, Livestream.
Alright.
Didn't the Welsh Highland also have one of those Baldwin tanks?
Sorry?
Didn't the Welsh Highland have one of those Baldwin tanks as well? You know, one of the 460s?
Think so? Oh, what, the wartime ones, you mean?
Yeah.
Mm,
remember correctly, sure. I think they've got one, and they want to, like...
Shit.
Convert it to make it the one that actually ran on the Welsh Highland.
Now, here's the question, lads.
What?
Should we ask the people in the chat how they are doing this day?
Can they still hear us?
I believe they can.
Let's give it a go.
Alright, everyone here, if you can hear me, type supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Yeah, as I was saying, Anthony, yeah, the reason why it looks like it's big quarry Hunslet is because it is. It was built Hunslet.
Oh. I can't believe they're still building quarry Hunslets, really.
They're still building them.
I swear to God, there was one that was built like 10 years ago.
Uh, 247 Productions, Tom's gone for a fag.
Oh, so
and yes, they can hear us. Jazz Productions. Hi, I am big fan. I just... Oh, fuck off. I think this is a jokey comment. Hi, I am big fan. I wanted to ask, what is your favorite engine?
My favorite engine is a...
Penis.
No, it's a... 440 Hemi.
I don't know what an engine is. What is an engine?
What's a train? What's a Percy?
What's a banana?
We're very rude.
There is a website dedicated to quarry Hunslets. And of course, Lilla, Charles, Blanche, Linda, they all count as quarry Hunslets as well.
And do they?
Yeah. Because Blanche, Linda, and Charles worked at Penryn, as did Lilla. They all worked at Penryn. And they were just basically bigger quarry Hunslets, slightly redesigned.
Of the lot, the only one that still looks like that is Charles. Because obviously Blanche and Linda were then turned into tender engines.
Well, that was when they came into the Ffestiniog.
Yeah, I'm actually going to look. When were they rebuilt?
And there's also Cackler as well. Cackler was a quarry Hunslet, slightly beefier quarry Hunslet, sort of in the same vein as Lilla.
Oh, apparently they were rebuilt in the 70s.
Mm. Yeah, and when they were rebuilding included a pony truck, so it became 240 as opposed to 040, and oil burning, which is why they have the tender. Because originally they'd have just carried a little truck behind them with the coal on the move. But yeah, I mean, as they were doing little operations in the quarry, they didn't really need to carry coal on board, as far as I'm aware. Well, there's quite a few quarry Hunslets in preservation, as you can imagine, because a lot of them would have ended up into... private industrial use after the various quarries shut down.
Yeah, I think, for example, the Bala Lake Railway's entire steam fleet is made up of quarry Hunslets.
You're a Bala Lake.
Uh-huh.
I've been listening to you, in the kitchen. You're basically doing facts and figures about, Blanche and Linda when I was listening.
Oh, I'm just looking at them now. I'm just looking at something that's a bit strange. I'm looking at the preservation statistics on them.
Uh-huh.
Obviously it says, after the closure of the Penryn Quarry, Charles was donated to the Penryn Castle Railway Museum. Linda was loaned to the Ffestiniog in July 1962.
That's a long loan.
And it was only in the 19... What?
That's a long loan.
Hang on. For the 1963 season, the locomotive was re-gauged to the Ffestiniog on foot 11.5-inch gauge. It's just like, wait a minute, so what? How is it running for its first couple of months there?
Isn't.
And then they were purchased. Linda and Blanche were both purchased at the end of that year.
Right. I'm just looking. The number of survivors which are in preservation are as follows: Alan George, Alice, Bill Harvey, Blanche, Breitemart, Cackler, Charles, Cloister, Covercoat, Dayman, Dolberdarn, Dorothea, Edward Shotto, Illidir, Ellen, George B, Gwyneth, Holy War, Hugh Napier, Irish Mail, Jack Lane, Jerry M, Jonathan, Lady Joan, Lady Madcap, Lillian, Lilla, Linda, Louisa, Maid Marian, Nessa, Pamela, Rough Puff, Statfold, Thomas Bach, Una, Velen Healy, and Winifred. Those are the ones that survived.
I'm looking at this though, and it's called the English. The Dinoic Alice class.
That's basically what it is.
11 built, all of them survived.
Yeah, and I imagine all of them were on the Flambaris Lake Railway, because that's right by Dinoic.
Let's see, four of them are on... Is it four? Yeah, four of them are on the Bala Lake. There's two on the Llanberis Lake. One of them's at the Narrow Gauge Railway at Swanage. Or Purbeck, rather.
Who is it? Which one?
Cloister.
Oh, okay. Interesting. I thought there was a quarry hunter there, but I couldn't remember whether there was quickly. There is.
It says Rough Pups at the museum at Tawyn. One's at the Statfold Barn.
Yeah, I would like a quarry hunslet. I just want to drive around in a quarry hunslet.
Right then. Latest project for Patreon. Let's go and buy a quarry hunslet.
Yes, I want a quarry hunslet.
The only problem is, we'd have to paint it purple and call it Welsh Guardsman.
Aww, I want the colour Gamma.
The fuck did you say?
I want a quarry hunslet, and I want to drive it down the M6.
You're going to stick road wheels on it.
No.
No,
just drive my steam engine in the middle lane, and just like, evening! Sorry, officer. I can't hear you over the sound of how awesome I am. I want that though. They are wonderful, charming engines.
Oh, according to Adrian Brown, Cloister is no longer at Purbeck. She left after Swanage managed to drop her while taking her into the workshops. Lol.
Haha.
There was another engine based at Penryn, which I think is quite an interesting loco. If I can get the picture up. If I can spell Penryn right. It's difficult trying to type something such as Penryn when it's only got one vowel in it. It's the D. Winton.
D. Winton.
Yeah.
Is that the vertical boiling engine?
Yes.
You know what? It's actually really interesting. And every time I heard the word De Winton, I assumed it was built in like France or something. But I was actually very surprised to hear that they were actually built in Wales.
And the picture I'm putting in the Discord, that's one that's basically an inverted name of my brother. Because my brother's name is... Oh, I know. George Henry Hancock. Yeah, so that's my brother as a D. Winton. What happened to you, George?
Obviously, he decided to sign up for that biofusion experiment.
Did he?
Oh, actually, that's the same thing.
A bit too fluffy for my feet at the moment.
Aww. Poor little Tommy.
Go away, Chris. No one loves you.
I know no one loves me. That's why I'm talking to you a lot.
Oh.
The rest of the outcasts.
I'm not an outcast. I'm a mechanic.
Yeah, you're an outcast.
What you are, though?
God, how much longer is this route?
3 miles.
Yeah.
I'm just looking. The D Windsors that were built for De Norwich, they were double flanged. Double flanged wheels on them.
Double phalange.
Hmm. Georgina, damaged beyond repair in Rockpool, 1904, Penryn Quarry. Okay. Who's the one that survived? That's Colono, isn't it?
Sorry, what is?
The preserved D. Winton.
Challoner.
Yeah, Challoner. That's it. It's ultra private, but... Oh god, there's another one, Kathleen.
Yeah, the couple of...
Another one, George Henry, is at the Narrow Gauge Railway Museum in Towin.
Your brother is preserved in Towin.
Oh my god! George, what happened to you? There's another one called... Oh god. Pendifrin, I'm guessing. Privately owned, awaiting restoration at Brecon Mountain Railway.
Never heard of it.
Well, the Brecon Mountain Railway.
You've never heard of the Brecon Mountain. Do you know why it's a mountain?
Well, I know of the name, but I've never really heard anything about it.
As far as I know, it had like a giant American logo.
Oh. Yeah, they do, I think.
Meanwhile, I've just found a picture of Charles. Wow, they do look really different. She does look really different, doesn't she, compared to Blanche and Linda?
I love how you say, wow, Charles, she looks really different.
I know, right? Duke of Gloucester, oh my god, she's so amazing.
Robert Stevenson, I love her Val gear.
Don't mean George Stevenson.
George Stevenson. Fuck!
Oh, Callum, you've seen what Chris Wilson's doing, haven't you? He's building a new manor.
Oh, he's building a proper manor. That's not shit.
You better mind your manners there, Callum.
Bum tits.
Give you bum tits in a minute.
Whoa! Shocking, Tom. That's shocking.
You can certainly tell this is Wales.
Oh my god. Mr. George Quayle is just rammed with facts. Oh my word. Charles is about 2 years older than Linda and Blanche.
Well, he is their older brother. Mm. Big brother, I'm in a museum. I used to be a cow.
Moo.
Oh!
Well, Corey Onslet used to be a cow.
I don't know whether you guys have noticed, but I'm trying very hard not to derail.
Well, your name is... your name is Brett.
I don't think you will, Tom, because Double Fairlies are articulated.
You know, the track is so curvy, I'm worried about the coaches more than anything. Oh, Christ, how far have we got to go? It's quite far.
You know, the Fairlies weren't built by Boston Lodge, were they?
Huh?
The early Fairlies, they weren't built by Boston Lodge, were they?
No. I think a couple of them were built at Avonside. I'm not sure about the rest of them, though. I think they did have a locomotive works even back then. God. See, I love narrow gauge. Because narrow gauge, I think, because it's more than just the locos, it's the company that ran it as well. Because they originally all started out as private railways.
I think you still want the Welsh Prawn Fanfare, don't you?
Yeah, I love the Welsh Prawn Fanfare. Because that's a little bit different, because that was actually nationalised. Because that was, let's see,
I think it was built as part of the Cambrian network, then it became amalgamated with the Great Western, and then it became nationalised. And the Vale of Rydal, I think they had a similar story to it. I'd love to go to the Vale of Rydal if I could.
I reckon I should paint one of them blue again.
Maybe.
Thing is, they're all painted Great Western green now, aren't they?
All of them. Oh.
Well, they all will be. Obviously, Prince of Wales and, what's it, Llewellyn are Great Western green. And then, what's the other one?
Owain
Glendower.
Yeah, that one.
Owain Glendower.
She's going to be green as well.
She was, Owain Glendower was named after a Welsh knight, and Owain Glendower is in my ancestry. So,
I thought you were going to say Owain Glendower is in my attic then.
But Owain Glendower, I know that for many years he carried BR green for a long, long time. And then there was Prince of Wales. I think Prince of Wales was originally painted in like yellow with Indian red frames or something like that.
I don't know about that. I know it was painted red recently, and then it went that sort of like black. With the Cambrian thing.
Hold on. Let me just Google Vale of Rydal 260. Because I
here, let me Google that for you.
I had, a few years ago, I had a jigsaw puzzle, and it was of Welsh narrow gauge engines, and there was a Vale of Rydal 262 tank in yellow with Indian red frames.
I've just seen this, though. Historic Welsh Railway Companies. There's, like, loads Great Western. Then there's a load that are London and North Western. Joint lines, independent lines. Those are, like, big narrow gauge railways that are still around today. We're actually independent. Like, entirely. Like, Ffestiniog, the Snowdon Mountain, the Tower of Flynn, Welsh Highland.
Ah, the Welsh Highland wasn't, though, much. The Welsh Highland itself only lasted for, like, about 11 or 12 years, something like that. Then it was closed, and then it was the Ffestiniog Railway that reopened it.
Because
It was closed and ripped up, I believe.
Well, technically, they're all part of the same network, as far as I'm aware. North Wales Narrow Gauge Railway network. So,
oh Lord, can you imagine what would happen if someone tried you'd build it in like a railway to just like all the big Welsh narrow gauge railways on it?
That'd be brilliant.
Great
little trains of Wales. Oh God, I found a picture of Llewellyn Owain Glendower. Oh, wait, no. Sorry, Llewellyn, Edward the Seventh,
Edward Scissorhands,
and Princess of Wales, the Prince of Wales, rather, in BR colours back in the day.
Ah, the Vale of Rydal have got a permaquip. Can we steal it?
Yes.
Awesome. I want a permaquip.
Now, Anthony, are you prepared to take the consequences of stealing it?
Well, I'm gonna have to kill a bunch of people.
Maybe.
No, that's fine.
Okay, so nothing to you then.
That's what we were expecting.
I quite like how there's quite a few narrow gauge railways which have their original locomotives. So, Welsh Highland, they've got Russell. You've got Ffestiniog, which has quite a fair chunk of its fleet, as does the Vale of Rydal. Welsh Gordon Llan Fair still have their two original engines.
Tower Flynn and Bobby have still got Tower Flynn and Dolgall.
Yeah. What else? Llanberis Lake, technically, because Clanberry's Lake Railway is based next to the Norwich Quarry, so...
Snowdon Mountain, you've still got all theirs. Mm-hmm. Except for number one, of course.
We are number one. Just shows what I said, and I'm probably going to get killed.
Moo.
Moo.
Speaking of the Snowdon Mountain, you know, what do you reckon is going to end up happening to number 7 and 8? Well, they're called Ralph and...
I thought 6 was Ralph.
No, 6 is Pagan.
Oh, that's right.
And 7's Ralph, 8's... I don't know, is it Eriri or is it Eriri? Like those two, they've been taken to bits. Their boilers were scrapped years ago and they're just sort of sat around. Apparently there's no plans for them. Do you reckon they're going to end up being scrapped or...?
Yes, I'm going to scrap them.
He's going to chuck them off a cliff.
Yeah.
Is that like your fetish or something, Tom? Just throwing engines off cliffs?
No. Don't know what made you think that.
257! Or a Seb made it. Boeing 257.
Alright, there we go. I found the pit whales in that yellow livery. One is a model, and one in real life. I think that's a stunning looking livery. That's another thing with narrow gauge. Because so many of them were private, it meant that they all carried their own colour schemes, and they all look fabulous. Even the Penring Quarry liveries, it's black, but the lining just makes it look so nice. It's just nice in general. I like it. Tom?
Yo?
I reckon you should convert the Dark Railway to narrow gauge.
You see, there was a talking before about the possibility of making the Soma branch narrow gauge in the future, or even abandoning the plans that I've already laid in place for the Mirkham Industrial Railway and making that all narrow gauge. But,
right, Barbourne Docks it is then, your narrow gauge.
To be fair, there is an idea that maybe possibly the well, I suppose the only thing I could possibly do is to convert the Bramley Railway to be narrow gauge.
Yeah, you could do.
No, you can't do that to poor old Cheapside.
But we need new engines to run it. Theo, Otto, we're converting you into quarry hunslets.
Oh, shit!
What about the tow cannon? What's a tow cannon? Nothing?
You won't be big enough to move the tow cannon now.
Oh, speaking of the tow cannon, I hear Barry stole it.
Yeah, I think he might have had it stolen back off him, though.
Watch this weird green Ian ketchup dispenser.
Then he zaps himself, and then suddenly his voice goes high-pitched.
Oh, dear! Oh, hell!
Turns into bus.
That stuff tasted disgusting!
He turns skanks.
It sounded like you were made of bloody, sewage. Raw sewage.
You look like raw sewage.
Well, your face is raw sewage.
Thanks.
I wish you didn't pray.
Ouch, I'm blind.
Good.
I opened my computer after playing a game and it was a white screen.
You're a white screen.
I cannot see, I'm legally blind.
Nothing done to add to that.
Good news, everyone. Once we get to Dinus, I think it's only about 2 miles to Caernarfon.
Yay!
Apparently, original Welsh Highland never ran any further than Dinus. It literally ran from Dinus to Port Maddock.
Yeah. I thought it was always pronounced Dinus.
Oh, no.
I imagine that probably some proper Welsh person will come up and go, "No, you got it wrong. It's not Dinus or Dinas." What is it then? It's
What?
What?
I imagine that'll be it.
Callum, you're not making any sense.
Do I ever?
No.
Valid point. Probably why you got Scotsman.
Why, yes. I am the world's famous flying Scotsman.
You're Salmon Trout.
Excuse me.
Salmon Trout. No. The famous LNR Pacific.
The famous Bully Pacific.
So in the flesh. The famous Bully Pacific.
I'm not Salmon Trout. I'm Flying Scotsman.
Who?
Flying Scotsman. 4472. The world's most famous express locomotive.
Bollocks, Alan. Hey.
I've never heard of you. Are you sure you're not Salmon Trout?
How on earth is Salmon Trout more famous than me? You two better start explaining some things to me.
No.
Oh my god, has Chris actually built his own, like, driver model for this?
Has he?
What?
Sorry, I've just seen some pictures that Glenn's put up of the, ones free. There's a picture of the driver. Is that on the actual model? It's like, you get a guy standing there. It looks like a custom model with a moustache and a pipe.
That's Chris, definitely.
Yeah, it's definitely the Chris moustache.
Gosh, and I thought my ego could be big sometimes. Then again, guys, we all know someone else's ego who's really, really big at the moment, don't we?
Yeah.
Anthony.
Yeah, mine. Because I am very important.
Why are you suddenly so important, Anthony?
Because you said so on your blog.
I didn't say you were that important, did I?
Yeah, you did.
Did I?
You basically licked his ass clean.
Whoops.
Wasn't I the incredible Callum Hancock?
Yeah, but Anthony got like three different parts about him. You only got one.
Yeah, but Dildo, I still got to voice Flying Scott.
Yeah, but Dildo, did you just say?
No, I still got to voice Flying Scotsman.
Yeah, and Anthony voiced
Arnold.
Oh. And Barry.
Who's it? I was.
And you pushed Lars.
Oh, that's Arnold, right.
Arnold and Alfred. Actually, you know what, Tom? I've noticed a little trend with the characters that you're getting me to play.
What? Yeah, they all start with Clough.
Yeah, I noticed that. Clyde, Clarence, and Clark.
And Clyde Clotsman. Chris.
Damn!
You didn't think of that, did you, Callum?
I will point out quickly, guys, we have gotten to Dynas, Dinas, how you pronounce it, with like 7 coaches with a double fairly, so it's not bad innings.
No, not
good. So now it's for the final push of this live stream, guys. We're going to get from here, we're going to get to Caernarfon, and we're going to explode. Right?
Alright, so full speed ahead. Basically,
we're
what you're saying.
Crash to a wall and die.
Yes.
Yeah.
And then we'll do the return journey. Hooray! No.
No. It's not the cat video.
Yeah.
Cat. I want to get Bob now.
Bad Fritz, down boy.
Tom. Hey. Tom, what's your water level?
I've got 81 in the boiler, I've only got 211 gallons.
Oh.
It's really good for water, these things.
Yeah. George, we're doing alright for water.
I've only got like 2-ish miles to go anyway, so...
This is going to be a rare opportunity where someone in the live stream is going to ask one of the viewers a question. George Quayle. Are you a volunteer on the Ffestiniog or Welsh Highland at all?
Yes.
And also I'm going to ask him, why is he red?
Yes, George. Also answer us why you're red.
So this is an... Oh, hang on. If I remember correctly, the bit from Caernarfon to Dynas was standard gauge.
Was it?
Either that, or it really didn't exist before. the extension to Caernarfon.
Is it Caernarfon where they're building that new station?
Yeah. Isn't there another narrow gauge railway at Caernarfon? Or starts at Caernarfon?
I think you might be confusing that with the Welsh called Llanfair, because the end station is known as Llanfair Caernarfon.
No. All the story. All Welsh railways sound like they're in the same place.
They are.
Wales. Story.
Ah. Mr. George Quayle, our lives.
Mr. George Quayle says that he's not a volunteer yet, but his father was a driver on the railway.
Well, maybe his father could tell us about the about whether the bit, what the bit between Dynas and Caernarfon was then.
Jazz Productions.
It's my penis.
Say there is a fire live at Broadway near my home. Save me! What are we supposed to do with this information, mate?
I can't you exactly.
You'll be fine.
I can't don't exactly go to Broadway. Where am I anyway?
I'm on a fire at Broadway. You mean a Broadway station?
You will be fine.
Bontnewid apparently were.
Bonk.
Have you thought about calling? Oh, I don't know. The fire brigade
or Ghostbusters?
Is that a I'm sorry, but who goes, oh no, there's a fire at a railway station. First thing I've got to do is go on a live stream and
talk
about it to a bunch of people.
Okay.
That's responsibility right there.
Yeah. I think he's talking shit.
I think I may be right about this bit being possibly an old standard gauge, because it seems that it runs alongside a footpath.
Hmm.
A bit like the camel trail at Bodmin and Wentford.
Ah.
You know, because at Boscastle they share Boscarn Junction, they share part of the camel trail, which is the old track bed.
Ah. Mr. Quayle, he's answering your question, Tom. It was part of the LMS line from Bangor to Appenwen via Caernarfon.
Oh, so it did go. So I'm presuming that the two railways met. That must be why the narrow gauge and the standard gauge must have met at Dynas then.
Nah.
Shut, Chris.
It sort of explains when you went through it. It was quite a big sort of railway yard, wasn't it?
So, yeah. So I presume it was used to be a, you know, an interchange.
Yeah. Well, apparently most of it is now a cycle track.
That's what this is, what we're running alongside now is then.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Still, I'd like to visit
a farmhouse.
I tell you what, a Double Fairlie has a lot in common with a Great Western Castle.
What, it's got a big arse?
Well, technically, the engine doesn't have an arse, does it? So,
yeah, she's got your ass.
But,
so why is a castle and a fairly got in common?
Four cylinders.
That's it.
Yeah.
So essentially, you're saying that a fairly is common, for example, to a star, a king.
Duchess.
Yeah.
There wasn't any southern four-cylinder engines, were there?
Princess Royal.
Yeah.
Three-cylinder.
A giant lesbian as well.
And let's face another thing that they have in common is that the livery is they shared liveries. They were either crimson or green.
When were castles ever painted crimson?
No. If we're going to do the general four-cylinder locomotive figures. I don't know. I'm talking shit.
Not the first time.
No.
Hey. I must have point out.
It's definitely for certain. Sorry.
No, you go on, Anthony. What?
One thing is definitely for certain, though, that it's true about a fairly.
Is it fairly awesome?
The splendid red fairly.
Ready for everything.
Red for everything. You'll never see them turn green.
suddenly turns green.
I will point out, guys, I'm very proud of myself for getting all the way along this line in one sitting. And not dying.
That's actually quite impressive.
Hello, Caernarfon.
Do you want a cookie?
So I made it from Blaenau Ffestiniog to Caernarfon without technically, only stopping at Port Madoc and having two cigarette breaks. I'm pretty proud of that.
How long did it take you, though? That's the thing.
Roughly 2.5 hours.
Well, that's not too bad, though.
Considering it's 40 miles at more or less line speed.
Right, let's go back.
No. We're going to finish.
Go back and try
let's
again.
Go back and try again. No, we're going to finish the stream here.
Yay!
Yay. No.
If it's 40 miles long, then surely the amalgamation between the Welsh Highland Railway and the Ffestiniog Railway is the longest heritage line in the UK.
It is.
And because you're sat there travelling at 15 miles an hour, there or thereabouts, you get a nice big long trip out of it.
Cheeky.
I think that's pretty good, actually, for a railway.
Hmm. The only problem is I don't think you can travel both railways in a day. I think you'd have to do one and then the other. So anyway, that then I'm afraid everyone is the end of the stream.
Woo!
Woo! So, if lads would like to say goodnight.
Goodnight!
Goodnight, everyone. Remember your own therapy.
And I shall also say goodnight. Thanks to everyone for watching, and I'll be back in a week's time or so. So, bye!
Bounty on you, overlords.